Maynard Keynes, the famous economist, said that. He said the problem is not with new ideas, it's getting rid of the old ideas, he says, which ramify into every corner of our minds. You know, and I would say into our being in that respect. There are certain things we are just very uncomfortable in letting go of. I mean, I always almost kind of slightly facetiously refer to the Copernican revolution. You know, we think, well, that was 500 years ago or whatever, and we've moved on from that, but we still talk about sunrise, we still talk about sunset. You know, the sun doesn't rise, the sun doesn't set, but we want it to. You know, we can't imagine our day without, you know, the sun coming up and a new day. And so there's an ontological dimension, as we call it, you know, that knowledge changes who you are, but sometimes we don't want to let go of who we are. And that actually stops us taking on some aspects of this new knowledge, because we're defended in a certain way. So I think an issue for colleagues very often is getting them to see that there are these, we use this formal term, ontological, you know, these shifts in being, which may be as important to some students as the cognitive dimension.
I think the thing that is most troublesome is differentiating between what a threshold concept is and an outcome or a core concept or a skill or ability. It's really hard to wrap your head around what that is. And I think that we are so ingrained in the language of outcomes that it's really hard to step back from that and think, well, wait a minute, is this an outcome that I'm expecting a student to achieve? Or is it a threshold concept that is bigger, broader, and that is something that is more like passing through a portal?
I think in the, I think it was either the first or the second paper we wrote about this, our concluding sentence was, and it's possible that threshold concepts themselves are a threshold concept in the sense that it may not be a self-evident approach to learning. I think a couple of things, really, that it's sometimes difficult to get a full understanding of what we mean by some of the kind of characteristics of threshold concepts. What we're saying is that these are not just important concepts, they're not just core concepts, which is a term people are probably quite familiar with. They are concepts which have particular effects. So you may be teaching a program in engineering or physics or whatever. A center of gravity might be a pretty important concept in the program you're delivering, and you would probably say it's a core concept. All students need to know that. But it wouldn't be a threshold concept in our understanding, in that it wouldn't meet the criteria that we're talking about. We're saying certain concepts have particular effects.
One thing that's challenging for me as far as thinking about the threshold concepts framework is, how do we take this really rich framework and start practicing kind of what we know? So for instance, how do we take our outcomes for programs, our outcomes for classes, and maybe existing structures, and start modifying them, having in mind what we know about threshold concepts? In a graduate seminar that I took on threshold concepts with Elizabeth Wardle, that was a big challenge for a lot of us, thinking about how, you know, what is the difference between an outcome and a threshold concept, and how do you assess a threshold concept? This can get a little tricky.
The other difficult thing is, I'm convinced since students are going to go through liminal stages, that's important. There's no set time for a liminal stage. Some of them will actually pass through the portal a year after graduation, 5 years, 15, 20. And if we really understand the impact we've had on our students, we really need to do longitudinal studies with alumni and do them probably consistently and figure out a way to determine where they are in that phase.